Well, President Marcos leads the distribution of seized smuggled rice in Zamboanga City. Our very own Queenie Casimiro now joins us with details. Queenie, what more can you tell us?
Yes, Carmina, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. led the distribution of confiscated smuggled rice to some 3,000 families in Zamboanga City today. The recipients are four-piece families from eight barangays in Zamboanga City. Bureau of Customs District Collector Arthur Sevilla Jr. says the sacks of rice are part of the 42,000 bags of smuggled rice seized from a warehouse here in Zamboanga City during an anti-smuggling operation on May this year. Sevilla says after undergoing due process, a deed of donation was signed by BOC and turned over the confiscated rice with a market value of over 40 million pesos to DSWD for distribution to identified beneficiaries, not only in Zamboanga but to other parts of the country. The seized smuggled goods are temporarily kept in the warehouse of NFA. 62-year-old Sally Karim from Barangay Kasanyangan says the 25 kilos of rice will ensure that his family will have food on their table for at least a week. He says their family could barely make ends meet with the rising cost of food and transportation. Karim believes the 20 pesos per kilo of rice promised by Marcos during the campaign period will not be fulfilled. Meanwhile, Marcos again defended his Executive Order No. 39 mandating a price ceiling for regular milled rice at 41 per kilo and 45 pesos for well-milled rice. He also reiterated the new price cap for dry palay at 19 to 23 pesos and 16 to 19 pesos for wet palay. Before coming to Zamboanga City, Marcos Jr. also distributed part of the confiscated smuggled rice to 1,004-piece families in Tungawan, Zamboanga, Sibugay. For ANC, Queenie Casimiro, ABS-CBN News.
As the Philippines deals with rice problems, one lawmaker seeks to establish a fund that would help local farmers. Agri-Party List Representative Wilbert Lee filed the Cheaper Rice Bill, which also creates the Price Stabilization Fund. Under that bill, the fund will be used for payouts and subsidies to rice farmers. Lee says it will ensure profit for rice farmers and affordable prices for consumers.
It's about 100 billion pesos po yung price stabilization fund na kailangan po natin dito. It's quite a big amount, but to me, it's a worthwhile investment that we need to do now. Marami po tayong napaglalaanan ng pondo, mga malalaking infrastruktura, and why not dito po natin ito gawin, no? Because I greatly believe that it is the main responsibility of the government, yung pong tiyan o yung pong pagkain ng ating pong mga bawat isang mamamayan.
Itaas yung buying price.
Agriculture group Sinag, meanwhile, welcomes the new buying price range of unhusked rice. The National Food Authority set the new buying price for dry unhusked rice to 19 to 23 pesos per kilo and 16 to 19 pesos per kilo for wet unhusked rice.
Matagal na natin hinihingi yun, no? Na itaas yung buy price, yung production cost ng ating mga magsasaka tumaas para at least hindi sila malugi in which nag-set ang price ng NFA para at least yung magsasaka magtatanim ulit.
Finance Secretary Ben Diocnoa hits back at calls urging him to step down. See, several agricultural groups are calling for his resignation, together with National Economic and Development Chief Arsenio Balisacan, over their rice tariff policies. But Diocnoa insists he only supports policies that are for the good of the country.
I serve at the pleasure of the president. No? Kung kayo na sa akin pangulo, pwede naman niya ako tagalin. Ganun lang naman yan eh. I have served for president. Hindi naman porque meron kang proposal na hindi ka angkop doon sa proposal ng ibang grupo, magre-resign ka na, di ba? You give your best recommendation. That is your duty.
Transport group Piston holds a demonstration to express their dismay with a string of oil price hikes. Jackie Minabat now joins us with that story. Jackie, over to you.
Carmina, a group of jeepney drivers or the Piston staged a protest rally in Caloocan to express their opposition to the recent oil price hikes. However, the rally was stopped by the police. The Piston member presented the letter he had submitted to the mayor's office that they had been granted permission to hold a rally. one of the protesters, 75-year-old Elmer Cordero, was one of the Piston 6 arrested in 2020 for protesting the loss of their livelihood. And he stated that they felt it was necessary to take to the streets to draw attention to their plight in light of the high oil prices. The prices of local fuel products have been increasing for the past 11 weeks due to Russia and Saudi Arabia's continued voluntary production cuts. Some oil companies have raised diesel prices by 2,050 centavos per liter and gasoline and kerosene prices by 2 pesos per liter, effective today, Tuesday, September 19. Pump prices have been on the rise since July, resulting in total increase of 17 pesos and 30 centavos per liter for diesel, 11 pesos and 85 centavos per liter for gasoline, and 15 pesos and 94 centavos per liter for kerosene. Piston has also announced that they plan to hold another protest next Tuesday or every time the oil prices increase.
House Speaker Martin Romualdez on Monday said lawmakers could recommend the suspension of the excise tax on petroleum products to President Marcos if prices continue to climb. Romualdez made that statement following a meeting with oil players. The speaker also told oil companies to help curb domestic fuel costs by cutting their profit margins.
I've also gotten some feedback from some of our congressmen here. Baka we can exercise this backwardization that we can already perhaps explore buying oil early or in advance, no? And not wait till December, so baka we can get better prices by securing our oil requirements and by making advance purchases or orders.
A price cap on oil not on the table despite soaring pump prices. That's according to House Deputy Majority Leader Congressman Erwin Tulfo, as House leaders discuss ways to cushion the impact of high oil prices on consumers. Tulfo says such a move is not possible due to the oil deregulation law, but he says a review of the measure can be done as they look into a possible oil cartel in the country.
In the government cannot just simply interfere or modify or do something about the prices because of this oil deregulation law. Not unless we ibasura natin itong oil deregulation law, but we can review this oil deregulation law, amend this oil deregulation law or do something about it. Kasi nga, if you notice, the world market announces that there's an increase, pare-pareho eh. Nakapagtataka na all of them, the big three corporations, pare-pareho. If you look at the small players, parang mas mura sila. We really believe that there is a cartel, hindi lang sa bigas, pati dito sa oil.
As for the excise tax on oil, Tulfo says government would lose billions of pesos per month if it will be removed.
4.9 billion a month we will be losing from the excise income. So times 3 months, that will be to the tune of around 14 to 15 billion. So that will be a problem.
What sacrifice can they make? Is there already a number with that? I mean, do you already have the number on the profit per liter of oil companies?
Doon sa usapan lang namin sa Congress, kami yung mga House leadership na pag-usapan, kaya nila hanggang 5
really?
To 10.
Manila's finance chief calling on proposals to suspend VAT and excise taxes on fuel short-sighted. See, there have been growing calls to suspend tax on fuel after local pump prices went up for an 11th straight week. Secretary Benjamin Diokno warns government stands to lose over 280 billion pesos in revenues if that suggestion is implemented. He adds the move might cripple the economy.
Ang ibig sabihin niyan, kung hindi natin babawasan yung spending dahil mawalan ng revenues at tuloy-tuloy yung pag-gastos natin, lalaki yung deficit mo, di ba? Lalaki yun from 6.1 magiging 6.4 ang deficit mo, percent of GDP. Pag lumaki yun, lalaki rin yung utang mo. Lalaki rin yung utang mo eh kasi mangungutang ka para tustusan yung kawalan ng revenues. From 61.4% of GDP magiging 61.7%. Ang mangyayari niyan, eh mawawalan ng kumpiyansa yung, di ba, yung mga credit rating natin. Eh pagka right now, kaganda-ganda nga ng credit rating natin, investment grade, no? Pagka nawalan yung ano yan, matataas ang interest ng panghihiram natin as a government.
The Energy Department, for its part, called on oil companies to do their part to help the affected transport sector.
Hindi naman ganun kasi kadali yan, kasi it's a collegial body na, tapos kailangan may approval of the House of Representatives and then Senate. Ang isang immediate na solution would be yung mga assistance sa mga drivers sa mga oil companies, na baka pwede naman sila tumulong din sa gobyerno kahit tatlong buwan lang, kasi ang expected nito is the next 3 months medyo mataas pa rin ang presyo ng gas. Hindi naman nalulugi yung mga oil companies natin. It's a small sacrifice or a short-term sacrifice for our oil companies.